Let's look at some trig expansions. Okay, so let's do two of them. We have to expand log of 1 minus 2x cos theta plus x square in a series of cosines of multiples of theta. So cos theta, cos 2 theta, cos 3 theta. So in that form we have to expand this. Okay, let's proceed. Log of 1 minus 2x cos theta plus x square we are given. Okay, so let's first take up this expression. So we have 1 minus 2x cos theta plus x square. Now how do we proceed from here? We might be tempted to rearrange it so that x square minus 2x cos theta plus 1 we get. But hold on to that thought. We need to come out because we need expansion. Most probably it looks like we will end up with something like 1 plus or minus, either 1 plus or minus x. So how do we do that? Now if you look at this part, cos theta and 2. So we have 2 cos theta. Now remember, cos theta can be written as in the exponential form, e to the power of I theta plus e to the power of minus I theta divided by 2. So if we take the 2 to the other side, that means 2 cos theta can be written like this. That is one thing. Second thing is, if we multiply e theta and e to the power of minus I theta, what do we get? We get e to the power of 0, which is 1, right? So it is a quadratic expression. So we will end up with a product and a sum, right? Okay. So now that we have got an idea, we can write this expression as 1 minus e to the power of I theta plus e to the power of minus I theta x plus x square. This is nothing but 2 cos theta. This can be factored into 1 square is 1. So we can write it as 1 and 1. Then minus into minus is plus. So minus minus. And we know e to the power of I theta times e to the power of minus I theta is equal to 1. And we get this 2 cos theta if we add them up. So this can be written as x e to the power of I theta, x e to the power of minus I theta. Now if you want to verify it, you can just do the opening of the bracket, distributively multiply it, and you should get back the previous statement. Okay, so now we have converted this into this form. Now let's include the log. Log of 1 minus x e I theta times 1 minus x e minus I theta. Now this can be written as, again it's a product, so using log rules we convert it into addition. So log of 1 minus x e I theta plus log of 1 minus x e minus I theta. And if we expand this, remember log of 1 minus x is equal to minus x plus x square by 2 plus x cube by 3 plus x to the power of 4 by 4 and on and on. Okay, so we, you know, apply this to our logs. So here this becomes minus. Now we substitute this x with x e I theta. So we get x e I theta plus, and we square it. So x square e to the power of 2 I theta plus x cube by 2 प्लस एक्स क्यूब ई टू द पावर ऑफ 3i थीटा बाई 3 प्लस एक्स टू द पावर ऑफ 4 e टू द पावर ऑफ 4 i थीटा बाई 4 एंड ऑन एंड ऑन एंड ऑन. दैट इज फॉर द फर्स्ट लॉग. नाउ लेट्स डू द सेम थिंग फॉर दिस. सो अगेन माइनस कॉमन आउट एंड वी गेट एक्स ई टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस आई थीटा प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर ई टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 2 i थीटा प्लस एक्स क्यूब ई टू द बाई 2 हियर माइनस 3 i थीटा बाई 3 प्लस एक्स 4 e टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 4 i थीटा बाई 4 एंड ऑन एंड ऑन. लेट्स कंबाइन दिस राइट. सो व्हाट डू वी गेट? वी गेट माइनस कॉमन आउट. एक्स इज कॉमन ई टू द पावर ऑफ आई थीटा प्लस ई टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस आई थीटा प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर बाय 2 एंड अगेन वी गेट ई टू द पावर ऑफ 2 i थीटा प्लस ई टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 2 i थीटा प्लस एक्स क्यूब बाय 3 टाइम्स ई टू द पावर ऑफ 3 i थीटा प्लस ई टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 3 i थीटा एंड सिमिलरली एक्स टू द पावर ऑफ 4 बाई 4 ई टू द पावर ऑफ 4 i थीटा प्लस ई टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 2 i थीटा एंड ऑन एंड ऑन एंड ऑन. ओके नाउ एंड वी कैन क्लोज द ब्रैकेट हियर. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस? वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन दैट दिस इज नथिंग बट 2 cos theta. ओके सो माइनस एक्स 2 cos theta प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर बाय 2 टाइम्स दिस इज गोइंग टू बी व्हाट? दिस इज गोइंग टू बी 2 cos 2 theta प्लस एक्स क्यूब बाय 3 एंड दिस अगेन विल बी 2 cos 3 theta प्लस एक्स 4 बाई 4 2 cos 4 theta एंड ऑन एंड ऑन एंड ऑन. हियर वी हैव 2 cos theta, हियर वी हैव 2 cos 2 theta. सो 2 इज कॉमन टू ऑल द एक्सप्रेशंस, ऑल द टर्म्स. सो वी टेक 2 आउट. सो वी आर लेफ्ट विथ एक्स कॉस थीटा प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर बाय 2 cos 2 theta प्लस एक्स क्यूब बाय 3 cos 3 theta प्लस एक्स 4 बाय 4 cos 4 theta एंड ऑन एंड ऑन एंड ऑन राइट. सो वी हैव गॉट इट इन टर्म्स ऑफ कोसाइन ऑफ मल्टीपल्स ऑफ थीटा. सो हियर यू हैव कॉस थीटा, कॉस 2 थीटा, कॉस 3 थीटा, कॉस 4 थीटा. नाउ हियर द ट्रिकी पार्ट इज वी हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट when we talk of log of 1 minus x equal to this, the condition is that the magnitude of x has to be less than 1, right? So which means here, since we are using this log of 1 minus x e to the power of I theta, that means x e to the power of I theta in one of them, and in the second log, it is x e to the power of minus I theta. Because this series says that the magnitude of x has to be less than 1, it means that the magnitude of this also has to be less than 1, right? So now here, e to the power of I theta is less than 1 and e to the power of minus I theta is less than 1. Therefore, xe to the power of I theta will be less than 1, that is the magnitude will be less than 1, only if x is less than 1, magnitude of x is less than 1. And same is the case with xe to the power of minus I theta will be less than 1, only if x is less than 1, because e to the power of minus I theta is less than 1. So just remember this, these two are in any case less than 1. So x has to be less than 1. Okay, so now let's look at the second problem, second trigonometric expansion that we are interested in. And that says sine x is equal to n sine alpha plus x. And we have to write x in ascending powers of n, where n is less than 1. Okay, so now let's see. Again, focus on the techniques. Sine x is equal to n sine alpha plus x. Sine x can be written as e to the power of I x minus e to the power of minus I x by 2y is equal to n times. Now sine alpha plus x can be written as e to the power of I alpha plus x minus e to the power of minus I alpha plus x divided by 2y. Now here this 2y and this 2y will cancel out. So we are left with only the numerators. E to the power of I x minus e to the power of minus I x is equal to n times. And here this we should put it in a bracket because n is applicable to both. So here this will become e to the power of I alpha times e to the power of I x minus e to the power of minus I alpha times e to the power of minus I x. Okay, now what else can we do? Let's multiply the whole thing by e to the power of I x. Then what happens? E to the power of 2i x, we multiply this and this. Now we get what? E to the power of I x minus I x, that is 0, which is equal to n times, again we multiply e to the power of I alpha times e to the power of 2i x minus, again here e to the power of minus I alpha times e to the power of I x minus I x is 0. Okay, so this becomes e to the power of 2i x minus 1 is equal to n times e to the power of 2i x times e to the power of I alpha minus e to the power of minus I alpha times 1. Okay, now what else can we do? Let's rearrange it. Now how can we rearrange this? Let's open up this bracket first. N e 2i x times e to the power of I alpha minus n e minus I alpha. Here we have e to the power of 2i x minus 1. Okay, now let's bring this e to the power of 2i x to this side. So we get e to the power of 2i x minus n e 2i x times e to the power of I alpha is equal to, this minus 1 comes this side, so 1 minus n e minus I alpha. Here on the left hand side we have e to the power of 2i x common, so let's take it out, 2i x, and here we have 1 minus n e to the power of I alpha is equal to 1 minus n e minus I alpha. Now e to the power of 2i x is equal to, let's take it to the other side, so that goes to the denominator and it becomes 1 minus n e to the power of I alpha, right? Looks similar, the only thing is here the exponent is positive, here it is negative. Now let's take log of both the sides. So we get log of, remember when I say log, it is to the base e. So e to the power of 2i x is equal to log of 1 minus n e minus I alpha. and since it is division, based on logarithm rules, I can subtract. So log to the base e of 1 minus n e I alpha. Now here what happens? Log and exponentiation gets cancelled. And I am left with 2ix is equal to. Now again we can use the log expansion. So what do I get? Okay, we have to have minus common out. We have already seen in this previous problem. We get n e to the power of minus I alpha plus n square by 2 e to the power of minus 2 I alpha plus n cube by 3 e to the power of minus 3 I alpha and on and on and on. Then we have plus, actually there will be minus again out, but there is already a minus sign here, so that minus and minus will cancel out and we'll end up with plus n e to the power of, now here there is no negative in the exponent, I alpha plus n square by 2 e to the power of 2 I alpha plus n cube by 3 e to the power of minus 3, not minus, 3 I alpha and on and on and on. Okay. Now here if you notice, we can combine these two series. So we get n is common to both of them times e, because this is positive, let's take it first. So e to the power of I alpha minus e to the power of minus I alpha, again plus, here n square by 2 is common, here also, so n square by 2 times e to the power of 2 I alpha minus e to the power of minus 2 I alpha, right? And then in the same way plus n cube by 3 is common, e to the power of 3 I alpha minus e to the power of minus 3 I alpha and on and on. Now remember, this can be written as n e to the power of I alpha minus e to the power of minus I alpha. If we get 2 I in the denominator, we will end up with sine. And that for us, we have this 2i here. So we take it out and here divide everything by 2i. So we end up with 2i, 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 right? So what happens is this becomes n sine alpha plus n square by 2 sine 2 alpha plus n cube by 3 sine 3 alpha and on and on. Yes, and on the left hand side we have x. So we have written x in terms of ascending powers of, right? So that's it. Bye.